Introduce today's chief guest, Honorable Sri Nimish Pandya, All India President Sri Satya Sai Trust, and a faculty member of Training in Integrating Human Values in Education. He holds Bachelor of Law degree and addressed several conventions in law and education. He has been on the board of directors of several companies. Currently, Mr. Pandya is heading a law firm of Pandya and Co. with several associates. May I now request our Honourable Chief Guest, Sri Nimish Pandya, to give an inaugural address with his words of wisdom.
A very good morning to all of you present here. I don't want to make it sound like a class, please heaven said, because I know one thing very sure, that in my days in St. Xavier's College, whenever there was a function like this, the immediate prayer was, when will they stop talking and when can we leave this hall and go home, was the first reaction. So being very conscious of that fact, I want to be in absolute awe and respect of all the students who are here, and I must congratulate you for being so patient and so nice, at least outwardly. Inside what you're thinking, I don't know. But that is the essence of human value that we're speaking today. What we show outside and what we are inside is the really underscoring of today's conference. I am very, very happy to be here, brothers and sisters, because of Narayan. And I'm sorry to call him by his first name because he's your principal, but I will always see him as a younger brother. Santosh has been a very, very highlighted student in the days when we were teaching human values many years ago, when he was a young boy. And I say this especially because I want to congratulate him and to you and to this institution. Because here success is guaranteed. You know why? Because when at the helm the leader is a follower of values, then down the line implementing can never be a problem. And I think that is the success. And that's the reason why I'm here today. It is often said in English language, brothers and sisters, that whenever the fish rots, it rots from the head, never from the tail. And that is today's story. Therefore, you are lucky that your beautiful fish at the MGM institution is headed by a person who is a follower of every word that he says. And that's the reason why I am here as his elder brother and as a guru of the times that he was practicing human values. Otherwise, in today's days and time, to give lectures is very easy. To be very impressive in public speaking can be very easy. But that's where our problem lies. You'd wonder why this whole course my brother Ramesh has at length tried to focus our attention. But let me begin with three quotations that have changed my life, and I wish that I would like to share that with you. One is, sow a seed of thought and reap a fruit of action. Sow a seed of action, reap a fruit of habit. Sow a seed of habit, reap a fruit of character. And sow a seed of character, reap a fruit of good fortune. Then, sisters, you realize that in life, everything begins with the first thought that comes in your mind. The second is the one that Bhagwan Sri Satsai Baba motivated me and laid down the peace for the path for the entire world when he said, if there is righteousness in the heart, then there is beauty in character. If there is beauty in character, then there is harmony in the home. If there is harmony in the home, then there is order in the nation. And if there is order in the nation, then there is peace in this world. And I wish to share these two quotations with you because this is what life is about. There is this journey with society, and then there is this journey which is inward. The first quotation leads the path to the inward journey. And the second leads the path to society. And this is where we need to see that on this graph of the journey which is inward, and the journey which is outward to society, we need to steadily grow on both these paths. One doesn't have a choice to do only one and not do the other, or do only this and not that. That's where today's seminar, or this whole two-day convention, becomes easy. Let me start with, why would we talk to you like this and why would this be necessary? Not because you belong to a religion, or not because that's what the saints have said, or not because some traditional people have told us this, no. Think for yourself, it's very important. In today's world, unfortunately, the youth has started becoming followers. When this country, India, said that youth were leaders, there's a great difference. There's a great peer pressure that drives the youth of today. And today's youth must realize, as I have realized too late in my life, that time is very important. I always have this thing which I tell to all my young friends is that, today I'm 65, but there was a time when I still feel I'm 18 and 19 in my St. Xavier's College. Because there was a time when I used to swing my hair and the hair used to go back like shaming a fool. But if I do that today, I'll sprain my neck. Okay? There was a time when people used to say, hello Nimish, how are you? But then suddenly one day somebody said, hi Nimish, bhai, how are you? And I accepted it. But suddenly one day I said, hello Nimish uncle, and I still accepted it. But I tell you, brothers and sisters, recently I was at a friend. And the friend had a grandson. So the grandson came running back after a function like this, and Dadaji, Dadaji picked him up, and suddenly introduced the kid, the grandson, ye Dadaji ko namaste karo. And I realized, gosh, that's a lot of difference. Time will not spare you. This day and this time in this beautiful MGM Technological Institute that you are studying as engineers to be, remember, you won't be like this forever. And time will not come back. Therefore, never ever ignore time, and that is the first fundamental value that you owe it to yourself and not to anybody else. The distance between birth and death is all set. This journey is always on and nobody can stop this journey for you. They say in 2045 they will decide that you will be permanently alive and you will never die, genetics. But I don't think that works today. Today you and I will die and the journey will end. How to end it is between you and me. And before you decide how to end, you have to ask yourself this question, who am I? Who am I? Why am I born? And that's very fundamentally true. And see the beauty of our country and our religions. If I'm a Hindu, I'm told, Divyatma Swarup Dula. I'm an embodiment of the divine. If I'm a Muslim, I'm told, Noor-e Khuda Ho Tum. If you're a Christian, you're told, God and you are one. Imagine my valuation. I am symbolic to reflection of divinity. See my purpose of life. If I am a Hindu, I am told moksh, whatever it means, but there is a higher goal to achieve. If you are a Muslim, kayamat ke din khuda ko jawab dena hai. And if you are a Christian, the day of judgment, you have to answer your God. Therefore, brothers and sisters, two things are very clear, whether you like it or not. That we are born very precious. We are not ordinary people. Secondly, the goal is very high. The goal is not eat, drink, and sleep. No, that's not the goal. Therefore, these two are important things to ponder over for every young man and woman. Then who am I? And see what we have done today. Religion and culture told us that I'm precious. I'm a reflection of God. What have I done today? For 60 years in science, I was told, whenever I asked this question to my teacher, to which kingdom do I belong to? And what was I taught? I belong to the animal kingdom. Am I an animal? I am not an animal. Divyatma Swarup Dula. Noor-e Khuda. God and I are one. This is what my parents taught me. And this is what my school taught me. I need to decipher, understand, we are not animals. We have a great destiny to perform. And look what we have done to the world today. My car, my BMW is more costly than me. If somebody scratches my BMW, hell will let loose. My BP will go up, my sugar will go up, everything will go up. My watch is more costly than I. Somebody can cut my hand for my watch. My house is more costly than me. Now, have you realized that my house has value because I stay in it? My watch has value because I wear it. My BMW has value because I sit in it. But we have turned the world upside down. The whole valuation process has gone haywire. But that's where Indian culture and spirituality, born as a synthesis of all religions, is going to guide us to revalue ourselves. This is a whole revaluation exercise that India needs. And this exercise needs to be started by you and I today, not tomorrow. This is my value. In India, what is the point of saying India is dirty, India is corrupt? What is India? If India is dirty, you and I are dirty. If India is corrupt, you and I are corrupt. If there is no hope for India, there is no hope for you and I, because we are India. India is not political parties. India is not institutions. India is not. You and I individually constitute what India is. And therefore, the whole ball, the whole buck ends at our table, that we need to do it. And the problem of today is, brothers and sisters, everybody wants to improve everybody else, but nobody wants to improve himself or herself. It was the years of George Bernard Shaw who said once that, why fool must you improve the whole world? Today everybody wants to improve everybody else, no? Ask your friend. Tu asa kar aisa, me asa kar aisa, tu barabar na hai, ye barabar na hai, wo theek nahi hai, isko theek karo. Are apna kya? Mujhe kaun sambhale? Why fool must you improve the whole world? Improve yourself and there shall be one fool automatically less in this world. Simple. Jod se jod jalate chalo, prem ki ganga bahate chalo. What a lovely song, we all enjoy. The beauty of light is this. You light yourself and automatically darkness goes. Asato ma asad gamaya, tamso ma jyoti gamaya. So beautifully people sing on the stage, no? So beautifully we light lamps. But that light in the lamp is the least important thing. Because if that symbolic light is not lit in my heart, and if I don't take care of this heart in my day-to-day life from breath to breath, what is the waste of time? Garlanding Sarvapalli Radhakrishna, waste of time if his values are not impacted in my life. What is the point? We're becoming a nation of hypocrites. We say something, we do something, and we talk something. In fact, I had a great opportunity by being by profession a lawyer, and the opportunity of sort of accompanying the doyen of Indian judiciary, Nani Palkhiwala, once. You heard of Nani Palkhiwala, right? The great Indian jurist. I was very young that time, and I was told by Bhagwan Sai Baba that Nani Palkhiwala is coming to a convocation in Prashanthi Nilam, where we have a university there, and that I should escort him as a young lawyer from Bangalore airport to Prashanthi Nilam, which is like a 3-hour journey in those days. Now imagine sitting with Nani Palkhiwala in the car as a young man. Suppose if you are a young engineer, and if I put you in front of some Nobel laureate engineer in the same room, in the same car, what will happen to you, you know? So as a young lawyer, I am all excited trying to create conversation with Nani Palkhiwala. And I am saying, Nani, why are you going to Puttaparthi, this Afro head, Sai Baba, Telugu chap, you know, what have you got? You're a Parsi and he's a Andhra Pradesh guy, you know, some godman, why are you going there? So he told me one night, he said, Nimish, I'm going there because of one quotation that Baba said. That is, that the end of education is character. And education is for life and not for living. These are two important things he told. So the conversation continued, and then suddenly I want to talk more on how to spend 3 hours. And I said, Nani, tell me, what do you think is the crisis that India is facing? His answer is stuck in my mind till today, brothers and sisters. His answer was fantastic. He said, Nimish, there is no crisis in India. There is no water crisis. In fact, we have so much water that we can quench the thirst of the entire cosmos. We have so much food that we can feed all the poor in the world. We have so much mineral resources in our motherland, Bharat, that we are the richest. So many ages people have looted us, but we still have money with us. Imagine today where we are, people are robbing India left, right and center, but still we are talking of a growth of 7%. Can you beat it? What a miracle it is. In a pot which has no bottom, we are having growth. Because everybody is looting everybody, isn't it? You know, no? Now the scams are a few crore. I mean, millions and trillions are the normal. First it was 1,000 rupees, 1 lakh rupees, and now it is crores and millions and trillions. But still, the finance minister says there is growth, 7%. This is like amazing. So then Nani tells me, Nimish, there is no crisis. There is only one crisis in this world, in this country today, and that is character crisis. India is facing only character crisis. Why? You and I, we are not integrated in our thought, word and deed at all. Imagine an engineer, he builds a bridge. He tells, I'm using good stuff, but the bridge collapses in 2 years. Or it collapses nowadays, not even 2 years, it collapses under construction only nowadays, and that fast, like, you know. So it's that bad. Technology, you guys are going to be a part of technology. Technology cannot be at the cost of human beings, no? Technology has to be a servant, technology can't be a master. And see today what is happening? Everyone with a mobile phone. Mother and father talking from two rooms on the mobile and SMS and WhatsApp. Have you ever gone for dinner to a restaurant? You see, between a boyfriend and a girlfriend also, they're texting each other on the dining table in the hotel. Or, it's crazy, the mother and father can't control the kid because the kid wants the father's mobile. If he doesn't get the mobile, he'll throw the plate in the restaurant. Give me up. So mother and father for phones have to give. What is this? Think. Necessary. And don't think it doesn't apply to you. Some of you may be married, not married, your life will go on, you'll face the same situation. And if you don't have the conviction and the morals and the discipline to control the situation, imagine what a state you will be in 10 years from now is unbelievable for you and I to decide. Therefore, now you said character is an important situation. See, today's parents, I'm a lawyer, I'll tell you the secrets. Husband and wife, just because he sneezes 10 times in the night, the wife wants a divorce. Or the husband didn't buy a gift, the wife wants a divorce. I mean, is this the family? The whole marriage institution is going to be finished. So all those who are dreaming, young boys and girls of marriage, please be careful. The lawyer is telling you what the reality is. Because the institution of marriage was a union of two souls. Today it's a contract. Today it's a matter of sensory issues. You didn't like me, I didn't like you. You didn't say happy birthday to me, helmet, you get out. I mean, this is the situation today we've come to. Look at parents. The father drinks at home, but wants the son not to drink. The father smokes at home, but wants the son not to smoke. The mother is fighting with her sister, but is telling her two daughters don't fight with each other. How is it possible? Teachers and inspirational people are the need of the hour. Practitioners of values are the need of the hour. People are yearning for role models. People are yearning to associate with goodness, but they're not finding goodness. They're not finding that environment anywhere which is coming. Satya Sai Baba had a lovely drama which he wrote when he was young called Chepina to Chestara. The drama was like this, that the phone rings in the house and the kid picks up the phone. He says, who's speaking? This is Ramesh Uncle. So Ramesh Uncle says, okay. Ramesh Uncle asks the boy, Bera, is daddy at home? So he says, wait. So daddy is there, so now the kid tells the son, tells the daddy, Ramesh Shankar is on the phone. Now dad doesn't want to talk to Ramesh Shankar because he owes him some money. So dad tells the son, tell him I'm not there. So what will the son do? Ramesh Shankar, daddy says that he is not at home. See, what does it show? That goodness is inherent in you and me. We are learning bad things. There is no effort to become good. There is an effort not to become bad. And that is the difference that we all need. You become young engineers, young technocrats. But what about good human beings? I remember a lovely story of a scientist, Maxim Gorky's story. Maxim Gorky once was a great proponent of science. He used to go in Russia all over telling people that science has done this for mankind and science has done that for mankind. And science, so he was going, so he went to one village with one of his lectures like me, he went there. Started giving all the lectures, one old man got up. He said, sir, I have a question. So Maxim Gorky was very happy. In the village, somebody asking a question to a scientist means a great thing, no? Like, I get very excited, somebody puts a hand up and asks me a question, just to realize, you may ask me, sir, when will you stop talking, you know, kind of situation. So this man also got up. This man got up and asked Maxim, sir, I have one question. So what is it? He says, sir, I'm amazed. Science has taught man how to fly like a bird in the sky. Science has taught man how to swim like a fish in water. But sir, unfortunately, science has not taught man how to walk like a man on the earth itself. See, this is the whole reality of the situation. Our mind is our biggest enemy. But I tell you one secret to the balance system, and it's completely free of charge from a lawyer, okay? I'm not going to charge you for this. What Swami taught me, he said, son, master the mind and become a mastermind. This is the problem where we have. In everyday life, in your careers, as it has happened in the past and it will happen in future, every moment of life, in every breath of life, you'll have two situations, either to do this or to do that. Okay? The mind will tell you to do something, and the conscience will tell you to do something. You know what conscience is, right? Everybody has. Some people accept, some people don't. Some people shut the voice and say, volume band karo, andar se awaaz nahi chahiye, bahar se acha hai. But some say, bahar ka band karo, andar se bada karo, kyunki andar se inspiration hai. This difference. What decision you take in a dichotomous situation with every breath and every second of your life will determine your happiness and pleasure. The mind has to be your servant. For example, I always give this example. Luckily my wife is not here, so I can give this example. That was my brother comes home. Okay? My brother comes home and says, "Bhai, I am in great difficulty. Please give me 5,000 rupees. I'll return it to you tomorrow." Now what happens? The brother talking to me, and the conscience from inside tells me, "Dede, bhai, give it, give it, give it." The moment I put my hand in my pocket to take out the 5,000 rupees, suddenly a voice comes from inside. "Ashi sunte ho kya?" Whose voice will it be? Tell me. My wife will come. "Come inside. What is it? Let's talk. So what do you talk?" "No, no, she don't give it to him. He's come inside. If you give 5,000, again he'll come to work. He will not work. Teach him how to work. He's not good to give money. Don't spoil his habit. We don't be good to him. Your goodness will spoil him. Do this." All solid intellectual convictions will happen. Now two things can happen, because I've been a dramatist in my life, so I'll give you two anki natak tumhara sangto. Pahila ank, bahar aalo, ani bhai ko sa aikla, marathi bolu thoda chalel, marathi thoda chalel na. Bhai ko ni sangela naka deu, bahar aalo to bhau, jaau de re baba, I can't give it to you, you are, no. Why don't you work? Why don't you take up a job? I'll help you take up a job, but I can't give you money. Now that man wants money just now and I'm giving him a lecture, okay? So he understands that this man doesn't want to give me, because all people understand. It's just we believe that they don't understand. We believe that we fooled them, but they understand that we have fooled them, okay? So he goes away. Now what happened in the night? My conscience has told me give, and I didn't listen to my conscience. My wife told me and convinced me that I should, on my mind. My mind says don't give, I listen to my mind. In the night scenario in the bedroom. In the bedroom, my wife is peacefully sleeping, but I am tossing in the bed because my conscience tells me you should have given it, you should have given it, you should have given it. Scene two. My wife told me don't give, but my conscience says give, because I am a practitioner of the inner voice, I am following my conscience. I chup-chup gave to my brother and said, "Chah, nigunza bhaal lukar." Wife comes to know, she's very angry. But seen in the bedroom in the night, she is shouting, but I am peacefully snoring and sleeping without any problem. This is the difference between following the mind in juxtaposition to following the conscience. And putting conscience into action, brothers and sisters, is human values. Because look at me and you. I am Nimish Pandya, so much is said about me, I am a lawyer, I am All India President, this, that, nothing matters. I am not one. I am the body, I am the mind, I am the spirit, I am the emotion. I exist at five levels. And for me to be a successful human being, I must be developed at all the five levels of my personality. My intellectual level, my physical level, my emotional level, my spiritual level, my understanding level. Imagine today's position. A fantastic surgeon, but a lousy father. A fantastic engineer, but a stupid husband. How does it matter? You may get a Nobel laureate for an invention in your engineering, but at home, if you are not a good human being, you are useless to society. And first of all, forget society. You are useless for your own self and for your own happiness and for your own peace. Because at the fag end of life, you will realize that you missed out the entire bouquet of flowers. You're holding one flower and you missed out the fragrance of all the lovely flowers. Now that is the problem that we need to understand, and understand that it is important that who you are is important. Today I'm standing here in front of you today. and I fall flat on the floor just now, and Santosh goes and calls the doctor, "Oh, Nimish Pandya to mar gaya." Immediately, my wife, who loves me and wants to live with me for ages and ages and ages, will not even call me by my name. Your body got out, yes. Because she also knows, you also know, that there was something inside me which was more precious, which loving wife has taken a dead husband home, which loving husband has taken a dead wife home, or forget that, which doting mother has taken a dead son home, or which dead doting children have taken their dead parents home. No, because we all know that there is something inside which is so powerful and so divine, which is the focus of our attention, which is the source of our energy, which is the source of all knowledge, which is very, very important, brothers and sisters. And focusing attention there is important. That's the conscience. And Satya Sai Baba used to always say that conscience is the seat of love. It's the truth. Because this conscience is what makes me alive in today's interaction with you. The day that is not there, everything is useless. My car, my house, my relationship, my trophies, my gifts, everything, my photograph, this video. What good is this video to me tomorrow if I am dead? And am I going to carry this with me? No. So focus your attention on what the reality is. And this reality is the source of truth. Now truth as thought, love as thought is truth. Love as action is dharma. Love as a feeling is peace, and love as understanding is non-violence. And I tell you, go home and think, and I give you this homework today, all of you. All the problems in society today, if you go to see, are all born out of lack of love. Lack of unconditional love. There is nobody to give unconditional love today. Everybody has a contract. A boyfriend has a contract with the girlfriend, the husband has a contract with the wife, the parents have a contract with the children, the children have a contract with the parents. There is nobody giving unconditional love to people. Love without reason. Just because I see that there is the same energy in you which is in me. The same power that energizes you is energizing me. And this is the secret that you understand. The faster we understand, the better we are in life and the more happier people will be. And I tell you, in the world we need people who can give unconditional love. And that is the path of service that not only our organization, but the Hari Om organization, all other spiritual organizations in this country are showing this path. We are all one together, but we need to unite together to be able to give unconditional love. The 50 mobile medical vans that he was talking about, can you imagine a villager who can't even leave his hut to go to a medical center of the government? How happy he will feel if a van comes to his doorstep and gives him, here is your crossin free of charge. That crossin costs 5 rupees outside, 10 rupees outside. Here is a chap who comes to your village and says, look, let's dig a hole, let's dig a well, let's keep water at the doorstep of every hut in a village. Can you see the beauty and the happiness in the minds of those women who have to travel 10 kilometers with matkas in their head if they find a tap in their own village? You and I can do that. You and I can spare our time in this process of service, which is nothing but unconditional love, which our culture taught us. Not Satya Sai Baba only. Not only one group or another group. Our great Indian tradition has taught us to. This is where we need to follow. What I'm urging today at the podium of this conference is that educated young men and women like you must spare time on 2-3 things in life. One, self-confidence. Very important. Don't be a follower. Don't get guided by peer pressure. Stand on your 2 feet with the voice of conscience. Do every sadhana possible, whatever your religion and your path permits you to do. Even if you're saying namaz 5 times a day, say it with so much of power that your self-confidence becomes great. If you go to church and pray, pray with so much confidence that your self-confidence grows and you become a master of yourself. You can tell your mind that you are my servant, I am not your servant. What happened to a young man who's a drug addict? He knows it is bad, but he can't because the mind is powerful. What happens to people who smoke in the corridors of college? They know it is bad, but the mind is telling them, peer pressure is telling them, their conscience is telling them, don't do it. But they can't do it because they are slaves of their mind. Greed, what is all? Imagine, it's a Mahatma Gandhi college, and I must say this, because I read it and I'm so inspired by this. Once Mahatma Gandhi was walking into Harrods in London. Imagine Harrods is the biggest store in London, which has the world's best objects of desire. So when somebody saw Mahatma Gandhi in Harrods, they asked him, Babuji, what are you doing in Harrods? You know what was the answer he gave? He gave his answer. He said, I'm standing here and I'm thanking my God that how I'm able to do without any of these things. I don't need any of these things to be happy. This is Mahatma Gandhi. This is the experiment with truth. And I would sincerely request all you brothers and sisters, don't think it's just one college that you come to. The name Mahatma Gandhi is an inspiration. It is not necessary to become successful by going to the best college in the world. You can become successful by going to the smallest college so-called in the world, but by improving yourself and creating your self-confidence into position. And the stories of self-confidence and nothing else. Because self-confidence is the first step to self-satisfaction. Self-satisfaction is the second step to self-sacrifice. Self-sacrifice is the next step to self-realization. If you're looking for happiness, self-confidence is the first step. And what human values can do to self-confidence, I want to end with the story of a young girl who was my student. This girl, Maya, today is a very accomplished Bharatanatyam dancer. She is world-renowned today. But she was a Bhadrika student like Santosh was many years ago. And she was going through the 9-year program of human values, where, based upon the 5 human values of Satya, Dharma, Shanti, Prema and Ahimsa, taught through the 5 teaching techniques of prayer, meditation, storytelling, group singing and group activities over a 9-year period, which only ensured that there was a habit formation on all these things for 9 years. At the end of 9 years, when she finished school and she was going to college, she went to college and the college is another atmosphere. Many of you have experienced that actually. When you leave school and come to college, it's a great feeling. It's a sense of freedom that you get. And so many thoughts come into your mind of I do this and I do that. So in the recess, all these girls, this Maya and her baby of friends, used to go across the street, there used to be a samosa wala. And the samosa wala used to give samosas. And you know how the samosa, they give it in newspaper, wraps of paper. So all the girls used to eat the samosas, pack the paper and throw it on the floor. But this girl, Maya, was a practitioner of human values and disciplined over 9 years of habit formation. Used to fold the paper and put it in her purse. Now what happens? All the girls, like any other college situation, started teasing the girl. Kai, kai vishadi karte, tu paper nahi tar ladke Mumbai swachho ho na ladke. What? Like peer pressure. You know how it is? You experience that, isn't it? You try, and the boys don't know. If somebody says, I don't want to smoke, then we tend to say, kai, it's like, maa dana, sutta kya parak parta hai. Bolne wale bahut hai. For the girls, no? You got 5 salwar kameez in the house, but if there is a sale, one get, buy one, get two free. You will still say, kai, yuta kare, yuta. Conscious is like, don't buy, there are already 5 in the house. But peer pressure. Taisa kare green hai na mata kare kuch bhi nahi aisa bhai. Day to day affair, okay. So this girl kept folding the paper and kept it in her pocket. And after 1 month, she came back and told me, Nimish, you know what happened? After 1 month, I did not giving up folding my paper and putting my purse, but all my friends started folding paper and putting in their own purse at the end of 1 month. This is the power of following human values and stick. You become the inspiration. Don't succumb to peer pressure. Do what is right and stand up for what is right with love and unconditional love and the foundation. Brothers and sisters, this is the story of human values. This is not something which the college wants to give it to you because the college wants fame and fame. No. The college wants that your life should change. You should become great engineers, great technocrats, study hard, do everything, but become good human beings also. Be sensitive to your own self and to your own world, to your own parents. Because if there is righteousness in the heart, that is goodness, there is character, the thought, word and deed become. If there is character, then there is harmony in the home. Today what have we done? We have destroyed our homes. How many of you respect your parents the way you should? How many of you are sacrificial to your parents the way you should? How many of us are getting selfish into our interpersonal relationship with our parents? Today, the isolated homes of people because of jobs and all that have created havoc amongst old parents in the families in the society. And today the trend is reversed, but not with honest intentions. The trends have reversed to call grandmothers and grandfathers home to look after their kids only because it is cheap. Not because you love your grandparents and then you sensitize what is happening. We don't want to live in this world. Let us not create this society in India. Let us not ape the West or any other culture to destroy our own greatness that we have, because India is the greatest country of the whole world. What we understand here, nobody else understands in the world, brother and sister. And this responsibility lies at your end and mine. We need to do it ourselves. Do not blame anybody. Don't point finger at anybody. Point your finger at yourself and see, how can I improve myself today? Competition is not competing with somebody else. Competition is competing with my own self every day. Am I a better human being today than what I was yesterday? If the answer is yes, sleep. If the answer is not yes, don't sleep. Find out what is wrong with you that I am not a better person today. These are the few thoughts that I wanted to share with you on this occasion. I want to congratulate Dr. Kedkar Jr. and sir as the convener of this thing, of this whole conference. I really congratulate you. Because today's need of the hour is this awareness. Today's need of the hour is not money. Now imagine all that we'll discuss today doesn't require 1 rupee. On the contrary, you will save so much that you will share whatever little you have with somebody else. That's the power of this whole human value that we talk about. Now as you study in this college for the few years that you're going to be here, please study hard. Your mind will tell you half the time not to do things which you should do. Follow your conscience. Do your meditation. Do your prayers. Prayer is the most powerful tool in the whole world. Meditation is where the mind becomes quiet, like a lake. If the lake is still, you see the bottom of the lake. When you throw a stone, you see the reflection of the world outside. Still your mind, go quiet, the power. Just to end with Vivekananda before I shut up my mouth as a lawyer, because the most dangerous thing you guys can do is to give a mic to a lawyer, okay? So, Vivekananda was once asked, sir, what would you study again if you were given a chance to study again? You know what he said? If I was given a chance to study again, I would not study history, geography, science or mathematics. But I would study that art by knowing which all knowledge is mine whenever I want it. And he was a great practitioner of meditation, silence. Even if you don't believe in meditation, believe in silence in your mind. Practice some moments in your day-to-day life when your mind shuts. And you get the inspiration from within. That is the message of our culture. That is the message. And this is not archaic. This is not old-fashioned. This is modern. Because the same thing is coming back to us from Hollywood, from all over Western countries, and we are paying thousands of dollars to go to classes to learn this situation, which we already know in our own birthright. And therefore, that's the vision that I leave you with. Thank you very much for listening to me. I'm so happy to be with you today. I don't know whether you are happy or not, but I'm very happy to meet all you guys. And congratulations. And may God bless you. May God bless you. And happiness for the rest of it. And may this institution of Mahatma Gandhi Engineering College, under the great leadership of my young friend, go from success to success. And thousands of young men and women, not only engineers, not only technicians, but great citizens of India, are born out of this. Jai Sahib. Thank you very much.